Hi guys, welcome to my channel. So first of all, if you are newcomer to my videos, help me to click the subscribe button below. If you are already my watcher or you already my subscribers, help me to click the likes or sharing will be great. Thank you. Alright, yeah, it's finished. Okay, let's start the video. Okay, this time around, I'm going to do the phone stand, which is a Hello Kitty phone stand. But I'm going to use two dolls for this time. And to be honest with you, if you're having like two dolls, it's fine actually. But because like the dolls actually have a different height and weight, so sometimes it's a bit hard to manage on my side, because as a phone stand, the doll supposed to be the support of your phone, so they will be like some adjustments I need to do accordingly, because I cannot be like having your phone be slanted as like one side is bigger than another. So yeah, just keep watching with me. Later on, I'm going to share with you like one of the I actually did this design before, but I'm going to share in more details like how I came out with the final ones. So here is my tools. So actually quite simple, there's only one tool I needed, is already in my video, y'all can check it out. I'm not very sure what is the correct word, but this is more to using like for like go for like flowers planting wise. So this time around, I'm going to like squeeze cream randomly, just like as much as I want to, like any, like it can be any amount that like, you think it can fill out the entire space. So y'all can, if you are already trying with this method, y'all can give it a try with like, you can go with like small amount first. If that is not enough, you can keep adding on. So this time around, the base is actually white with light pink. Yeah, and this is what I do, like if you have like any difficulty or like you think that the one is too plain in a way, you can add extra colors onto it, and it kind of creates a very interesting gradient as well. But if you feel that you cannot fill in the entire thing, actually if you turn the tools upside down, you can see that there's actually a huge amount behind, so you can like just scrub it at the edge and just like continue doing your actions, like your scrubbing, until it's flat as you want, you wish it to be. For this time round, I'm not going to do like very like nicely blending, because it is a cream, right? So you should have like some textures of the fake cream. So I'm not planning to do like the cake style, like the birthday cake style, like it's very smooth in a way. So this time round, I'm going to do like some patching, some textures onto it. So I wanted to share more things before I start with all this. So when I was first come to like these two dolls, right, I was like very excited, because like the Hello Kitty dolls is very cute. It was one of my travel videos, but but not my favorite. Y'all know what is my favorite, right? Okay, and this time round, the dolls is actually come from two series. One is the Sleeping, I think it's the Sleeping Beauty series. Another one is Career series. For this one, right, if I'm not wrong, this is actually one, this under the career of baking cakes. Yeah, it's a baker. So yeah, it's actually quite interesting, because I feel like there is a lot of dolls right now have a title of like something series, like blah 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 series, and I mean it's a way of selling from the seller side, like a selling point. But I feel yeah, it's like kind of, you know, like grab our buying interest into all this, because like it's all different characters and I just wanted to get it all. Yeah, I think that is the main part of the overall of like blah 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 series. Yeah, so y'all can see like the way I squish, right? Actually, I didn't do much different styles compared to last time, by adding another extra frame, which is the one that I'm squeezing right now, the white color one, to find to form a boundary between the creams of the cream style, and in a way is actually more nicer finishing, because once I squeeze the cream, as you all know, the cream is not it's not like the same size, so the base might be a bit messy. That is a way I can keep it everything clean in a way. So right now I'm going to add on all the charms that I'm going to use for this phone stand. And yeah, you also right, the rabbit ears that I placing in front the support of the phone is really very cute. When I was like first saw this, right, I was thinking of like, actually I wanted to have the ears on my handphone. But after all, I feel like maybe I can try with this first, because like, you know, if I put on the phone, right, it's like a way that it stands out. It's like something like my previous design, which I have a door that on top and the face is facing the users of the phone. So it's a way very cute, but okay, currently there's no one suggest this yet, but I'm going to try out one day, like having the ears on the phone casing itself. That is what my intention. And later on, I think the middle of the month, I'm going to upload a new video that I created another squeezing method, which I feel very proudly, and it's really very nice. I actually did it for my own when I first saw that door, and the door itself is like super cute. I think I might be uploading like around this or next week. Yeah, it should be around this timing. And yeah, so if you guys wondering, right, most of my video was created like around 1 month or at least like weeks before. Okay, I'm not saying that I'm slow in process. It's just that because I got a lot of videos I need to edit on, and sometimes I already forgot what is the exact day I made of all this. And yeah, like looking back of all my video, also like reminds me of like the orders I have come so far, because every order I need to have a conversation with the person who is buying, and it kind of like creates a relationship between the seller like me and the person who is buying. So I feel that it's a way, how to say, it actually changed me of like communication, like how to talk to people, like in that I never done or never tried before in the real world. And the way we should speak is also like quite interesting, because the mood or the words that you are typing actually affects one another. Yeah, that is actually what I have learned like so far. And when I looking back at my videos, really like reminds me all of this. And actually I'm quite proud that actually I am able to come until this far, because from the first sign actually was wanted to like just play with it and just like go with this, and I feel that this is interesting, but I never thought of like being as a business for this long run. I think I will just continue with what I'm going to do, but you know, like sometimes it's still a bit tiring, but I think I will just keep it on with honestly. But yeah, y'all knows right? Yeah, but if you really watching my video, you never like my videos, that will be that will be hurt. It's hurting my feelings. Yeah, I can see like the difference, you know, like the first video that I made so far, there are still people watching, which I really feel very grateful of that. And yeah, then there is a lot of things that happening in my channel as well, because I don't know why there is a lot of videos have been banned of like the right or copyright claims. But I have never used like those like music with those copyright issues. Yeah, but I'm still figuring so far. So some of the videos I might need to like just put it as private, because I cannot be like putting the videos and just let people to monetize of that, right? Yeah, that is totally unfair for my side. So I'm still sorting out the issues with the YouTube channel and the copyright issues. Hope you guys like the video so far, and if y'all have any questions, just comment below. And thank you guys for watching.